I am very glad to meet you. I want to discuss about Emerson's the great work, the American scholar. Emerson was delivered a speech at Cambridge in 1837. His speech was published by Emerson in 1838. He republished and include his essay in his books and changed his title as the American Scholar. The text, American Scholar text, begins with introduction by Emerson. Introduction deals about the American scholar's nature. The scholar is man thinker. In introduction, Emerson explains that his intention is to explore the scholar and scholarly function as whole human being. Yes, the American scholar is a man thinker. According to ancient fable, there was once only one man who was divided into many men so that the society could work properly with more efficiently. However, the society has subdivided to an extent it has no longer function and serve the good of citizens. Formerly the scholar is a man thinker, but now mere reader. But Emerson hopes to correct successfully by re-familiarizing the audience how true scholar is educated and what kind of duties of scholar are. The text begins with an introduction by Emerson, but the American scholar text divided into four sections. First three sections discuss about the influence of nature. Second section discussion about past and books. Third section discuss about the action and education of man thinking. The last section discuss about the duties of the scholar, and then Emerson discuss about his views of present America in his own time. Another one important concept is the influence of nature, because nature is a great teacher which instructs individual observe to see the natural world. Yes, there is a similarity. First one similarity is order. Second one is circular power. Order means if you see the natural world, there are so many things are existing. So many things are existing. The existing things are properly ordered. We must find out the reason why these different things are properly ordered, because to comparing and find out the distinction between the different things. Yes, this kind of order is a same similar thing between nature and the scholar's spirit. Second similarity is the power of circular power. The circular power is also another similar thing between the nature and the scholar's mind. Yes, it's a common maxim, that is, know yourself, you can understand the nature. Yes, as a scholar, if you study about your mind, you can understand the nature. It is a great similarity. So, nature is a great teacher. It instructs us to understand the self. If you know self, if you know yourself, you can know this whole universe. As a scholar, you must think, you must develop your scholarly attitude. And the second one is the influence of past and books. The influence of past and books is also most important thing. Yes. The past experience is better one to know the present research or to know the present exploring. And the books also carries a lot of message, a lot of ideas and concept. Books are written by so many great writers. We can get the past knowledge by reading and analyzing the books. But at the same time, Emerson says that another important one, that is, books are dangerous, because sometimes it may change as books may become as a great obstacle, because it stop our individual learning. We may lost and we may away from our individual talent. Thank you. We can discuss this topic in next